Good morning, Second Baptist and guests. The history of Second Baptist Church of Ypsilanti, a great church. Much of our early documentation is from the city directory and also the early paper, the Ypsilanti Commercial. Prior to 1860, Second Baptist worshiped with the whites at First Baptist Church of Ypsilanti. And it was customary when three colored families lived in a city or town, there would be a color line drawn. And it was in this case. So in 1860, the Second Baptist Church proudly became the First Baptist Negro Church of Ypsilanti. With the membership of 11, they first worshiped in a building near the Huron River, and later various locations, such as the Old Presbyterian Church and a location on Babbitt Street. Reverend Henry Jacobs' meetings was held in the colored schoolroom in the Adams Street School, which we know as New Jerusalem Baptist Church. They later purchased the Old Presbyterian Church for $1,200. The permanent location where we are now located was generously given to the church and their heirs forever by Mr. Charles Patterson and his wife, Ellen Patterson. It was held in trust by First Baptist Church trustees until 1953, when there was going to be a building program, and it was for the building of the parsonage. Then it was transferred to the Second Baptist Church and its members. We will share a video that will preview the history, beginning with Reverend Jacobs and the many pictures that we have over the years. And also included in this will be in 1934, we will highlight Reverend Garth Robeson Sr., who was pastor at the time, and for the purpose of building the parsonage. It was built during his time and a beginning of the building program. Then in 1960, Dr. B.T. Hopkins became pastor and completed the building, and we also had two endowment scholarships, that was one at Eastern and one at Washtenaw Community College. Then we moved to present, to Reverend George Wattles, who is now our pastor. So now we will reflect with the video on our past history.
And they were singing songs, they were talking like this. They said, you know,
oh,
Reverend Wattles led us to through one of the most difficult times in history for the church, businesses, and for us as individuals, the pandemic. And he continues to lead us with his special skills of technology. We are into a different time, a different method for worshiping. For now we're in the digital era, and also a Q code, where it's paperless and we're using our devices. But thank God that he gives our pastor a vision. He continues to teach, preach, and win souls for Christ, making disciples for Christ. And for that, we are thankful through connection, commitment, and community. Thank you, Pastor Wattles. However, we are at a moment in history where over the years, over 50 years, our building has experienced wear and tear. And we are asking, and it is in desperately need of repairs. And we are asking you, we are appealing to you to support as we make a great church greater. And glory to God is our thank you.